Everyone, our report for today is about bone pinning. So the indications for bone pinning is the treatment for high velocity injury, primary or metastatic bone tumors, gunshot injury, automobile accident, fracture, and trauma. So next, the signalment. In this surgical procedure, we did not use any live specimen, but we use a bone from a pig. So the species porcine. For the surgical anatomy, the craniomedial surface of the radius and the caudal lateral surface of the ulna are not covered by muscle and can be easily palpated to serve as landmarks for location of the incision. Extensor muscles are located cranial to the flexor muscles, caudal to the radius, and can be retracted to expose the bone. The cephalic vein crosses the medial portion of the distal radius, and the lateral radial head is palpable beneath the extensor muscles of the forearm. So here is a picture of the radius and ulna. So for the preoperative preparation, the same is done with the bone plating procedure. So there should be a thorough physical examination and laboratory test, most especially in older patients. And for non-elective and elective surgeries, of course, there is also need for laboratory tests to find if there are any other infections involved within the patient. So for the operative technique, casts, intramedullary pins, and external skeletal fixators were administered to the bone of the specimen. So first is the casts. These are used to stabilize closed, non-displaced radio-ulnar fractures in patients with fracture assessments of 8 to 10. So a Robert Jones bandage was done. In patients with assessment scores of 8 to 10. So in intermedullary pin, Steinmann pins and Kirchner wires may be applied as cross pins to ensure juxta-articular segments in animals with high fracture assessment scores. So in our procedure, we just fractured the bone obliquely, so we did not use any of the Steinmann and Kirchner wires. So we use a normal grade placement of the IM pin in the ulna. So in doing this, we insert the pin so that it enters the bone proximally in the craniolateral trochanteric fossa on the greater trochanter of the ulna. We directed it caudally to glide along the caudal cortex and seat it in the caudocentral aspect of the condyle. So for the skeletal fixators, we did not use any of this shown in the picture, but we use circlage wires. So as you can see here in the picture, we are drilling the bones and we use a plate to stabilize the bone, as well as we use it also as landmark so that we know where to drill and to stabilize also the screw. The same is shown here in this slide. In here, we are putting the screw into the bone. So this is the result of the bone pinning procedure that we did. So we also put circlage wires on the fractured bone, along with the plates also.
dito naman sa may post-operative care, analgesia should be provided to the patient. Then, of course, follow-up of radiographs are made to evaluate implant location para ma-check natin if wala namang problema dun sa may inano natin, inopera natin. Then, of course, we should limit the physical activities, kaya lalagyan natin sila ng leash for walking and physical rehabilitation until the fracture has healed. Physical rehabilitation encourages controlled limb use and optimal limb function after fracture healing. Radiograph should generally repeated at 6-week intervals. Then sa complications naman is intramedullary pin placement through the carpus causes degenerative joint disease and loss of function. Dito sa may intramedullary kasi pumapasok ka dun sa may trochanter. Tapos syempre yung madadaanan mo dun is sa may pagloob mo nun sa may cavity, malaki yung chance na magiging degenerative yung mga diseases doon. Then inadequate rotational stabilization for transverse or short oblique fractures causes delayed union or non-union, especially in toy breed dogs. Then premature removal of fixation from slowly healing distal radial fractures contributes to the formation of non-unions. Then valgus deformities after comminuted fracture fixation occur because of malalignment with the external fixator. Then malunion, delayed union, and non-union in animals treated with external coaptation.